Hello, everybody. Welcome back to XCOM 2. My name is Grendis, and we are here deciding on if I should buy something here. I don't really use PCS chips, so I guess not. In any case, I guess let's just get right into it, huh? Experimental ammo is done in 1 day. Spark is almost done in 11 days. We might get a spark before the next operation, although it's very unlikely in my mind. I think we have... Hold on. Go back. No, go back. I need to make sure all engineers are staffed. Seems like they are. Yeah? Yes, all engineers are staffed. Okay. Power relay. We shouldn't need... I mean, we shouldn't have a power issue, especially since shield power coil is completing in 24 days. So, yeah. I mean, if we get another engineer, that would be nice, but I don't think it's up the utmost priority right now. We could bomb this facility. I mean, pretty much for the hell of it. What else do we got here? Making contact, West Africa. So I need to make my way over there, which means, yes, making contact with West Africa. Mainly to get my income up would be,
setting course for Sector 11,
in my
West
opinion anyways,
Africa.
The best option here. Oh, yep, that thing needs to blow up.
The aliens are still moving forward on the Avatar project. Taking out that facility would deal a serious blow to their efforts.
Venom rounds, that's not the most impressive thing in the world, but okay. I could have sworn you could work on multiple Proving Ground projects at once, but I might have made that up. So,
interesting choice. I'll send word as soon as we're finished, Commander.
I don't really know why I need blue screen rounds right now, but might as well have them ready. They've completed R for R, really? Okay.
Commander, we've located one of their facilities.
Really? Where? Oh, it's on the way there. Okay, well, I'm perfectly fine with...
Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar project.
With that...
If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
Oh my god, that'll be fun. And by fun, I mean horrific.
Long live the Resistance.
Regional contacts located.
Okay, alright. I wish, if this is 5 days, then we'll work on it. It's 6 days, of course. Maybe we should bomb that facility then before it gets to completion. It's very tempting to do that, yes. 5 days until the spark. What is this? 33 less intel. That's kind of nice, but not necessary. Hold on, is Grimori available? He is not. 2 days, okay. So in 2 days, we'll do it. 1, 2, okay.
We have the position of a vulnerable UFO that's set down in this region. If we move fast, there's a chance we could recover a nice haul of supplies and equipment.
Okay.
Setting course for West Asia.
Let's see how this goes. This is a very, I mean, this is a really, oh, I'd love to blow that up, actually. Oh, I know why this, we must have barely seen these, because we rarely are hunted. Or at least I wasn't in our previous season. Okay, so how do we do this? Close combat is a thing here, so I don't really mind that he's shaken. I can just put a mind shield on him, so that solves that. Hex? Yes. I guess Hunter's Axe, too. Hold on. What are you doing? Armor available, weapons available, and utility items available. Grimori definitely coming. And we'll give him... I guess it really doesn't matter. Samuro, Venom Rounds, no. Nanoscale, sure. You, sir, get the Frost Bomb. And I guess a Smoke Grenade. Give him the Martini and Spitfire. I like these three here. Isaac for close range combat, Grimori for intel collection mostly, and a Grenadier. So Alejandro Padilla as the Grenadier. Brianna, I don't mind bringing Brianna along. Ooh, we could bring Hylord Fordring. Yeah. And we have a sniper here. I mean, this squad's actually kind of okay. Samantha gives us the advantage outside. We lose the advantage inside, though. We could bring some of our submachine gun classes just because I don't really feel like they have much of representation. And that's probably my fault, too, because, like, I'm so not used to using them. I'm kind of okay with this. If we take Varus and give him the dagger, actually, because this has guaranteed damage in the stock, so maybe that'll be useful. Well, I know who's getting the Venom round. It's not him. The pistol opens up an interesting tactical decision. Brianna with Minerva, that's, I think it works. We could give someone a bolt caster as well, then. What is the hardest hitting gun that I have here? Repeater, advanced scope, eh. What kind of upgrades do we have, then? Nothing. Wow. That's a bit surprising, but okay. As crazy as this is, I kind of want to use Asphalt and upgrade it. Because that seems like it'd be pretty good for Tyrion. Venom rounds. I don't really know how front load magazine will synergize well with a ranger, but we'll see. And there's one that I have an advanced holster on, right? Oh, I do. Yes, it's just not aimed. Okay. I guess we'll also give Brianna the skull jet. Well... then she wouldn't have a grenade, but that's okay. We won't really have a flashbang unless Alejandro is a flashbang. Okay, if we have a flashbang, never mind. Yeah, Alejandro is really awesome. Everyone's really awesome, though. Wait, so what kind of gun is Asphalt? I need to make sure I'm upgrading the correct gun here. Asphalt, French Lizard. Where's Asphalt? Oh, right here, okay. So, I don't know what the hell that is. I guess it would be a... it's not an M16. XMI-77? Is there no way I could actually see what the base model is? Well, I'm gonna upgrade the XML-77, or XMR, or whatever it's called. And hopefully this isn't wasted money, but we have a lot of supplies, so even if it is wasted money, which I hope it's not, it'll be fine. Or we could save money for the Spark. But eh, whatever. We have a lot of money coming in. Where is it now? So that's 100 down. And let's see if this is upgraded. It did. Okay, good. Pretty much good to go then. Isaac Yosef, Grimori Dragonova, Alejandro Padilla, Brianna Quinn, Avaris Shalone, and Tyrion Fordring. Welcome to the squad, by the way. This is Operation Perilous Gift. It usually is, yeah. And we'll see how this goes. We most certainly will see how this goes.
Skyranger deployed. Squad green to deploy.
I think I've done this type of mission maybe 3 times in my life. So I'm pretty sure these missions are always the same in terms of what happens during them. But usually what happens during them is hectic stuff. We'll see though. This is listed as a very difficult mission.
But apparently the resistance managed to disable a UFO that set down in this area. Unfortunately for them, alien reinforcements moved in before they had a chance to pull anything off the ship. We're heading in to take whatever we can. Secure the site and eliminate all hostile contacts.
The resistance forces must have hell of a kind of artillery if they could shoot a UFO out of the sky. Or maybe it's just like a large EMP bomb or something.
Menace 1-5, UFO site coordinates locked in. Move.
Holy mother.
Neutralize all hostiles. Rolling.
That's a ton of enemies in there. Okay, I mean, if we had a sniper, which we don't, we have a building to work with, but we don't, so that's kind of a moot point, I guess.
Attack.
Okay, Isaac, what do you see? What do you see?
They are bacteria.
Okay, 4 outside. Not too bad. I guess let's just get into position to shoot them.
Gotta cover.
Which means cover on this turn, preferably. Yes.
On it.
I feel like I'm always fighting like near this kind of building on most of these Arctic maps, but I could be making that up because I remember it being surrounded by a chain link fence and whatnot.
Moving on target location.
Let's not move too crazy.
I was just about to suggest the same thing.
Oh, good.
Let's do this.
Not alone. Oh, it's Lone Wolf. Okay, I get it. What's left side group gonna do? You're gonna go away? Okay, I mean, I don't want you guys to go away. Okay, that's fine. I could use Lightning Strike right now to just kill these two, but I feel like we can kill them without it. If we can't, then what's going on? So I say we just go ahead and overwatch and do this. It's only 2, we're taking a lot of shots at these guys. Yeah, I say we do it.
Affirmative. Moving out.
We shouldn't really need to use abilities or anything crazy on these two. But who knows, maybe I'm effing up here. I don't think I am, though, for once.
Okay, sounds good.
We can react with Grimori if it's needed.
Eyes on the prize.
Cleft shot, that's pretty cool. Yeah, let's do it. Custom sounds are nice. This is okay, because they'll activate and then move. Oh god!
Target neutralized.
Well, one's dead.
Irrelevant.
Shoot him again, Isaac. What are you doing? Oh, did I not put Alejandro on Overwatch? Damn it. Oh well. Well, I guess let's just start shooting. That works too.
X-ray neutralized.
Just keep on shooting.
Not even close.
Who cares? Keep on shooting. Is this advanced? It's a normal stock. Okay. I didn't think that would be a hit. But that definitely was a hit.
Rolling.
If we can overwatch people, that'll be nice. Oh god, they're checking up on what's going on out here.
First impressions are important.
Come on, hit. Nice.
They're flanking my position.
Well, he dodged, but that's okay.
Menace 1-5, we just picked up an outbound signal coming from the UFO. It's some kind of distress beacon. You need to get inside that ship and shut down the signal.
Oh, we're sure.
Before they send their whole fleet after us.
Okay, can do, don't worry. We are okay, probably. I think now's the time we use a grenade. Pretty much for the sole purpose of getting their cover removed. Yeah, I say we do it. Here's our first grenade of the day. Can I not hit all three? Well, I'm not really happy with this explosion radius, but it should be fine. I think this blows up enough.
Grenade!
Or not. I really should learn from my hubris at some point.
Is that a problem?
That is a problem, yeah. What are you doing? Because I don't know what it is. I guess if there's someone else I should be focusing on, it would be this troop in the back. So let's do it. Wow, 7 damage and a stun too. Nice. We should be able to remove these people in my mind. I still feel like we should be able to do it. Not in the most ideal of ways, but it should be possible. Clutch shot, eh. If we had an upgraded pistol, that would be a lot more interesting.
Move into position.
I wish this was a safe move, except I'm pretty sure it's not. I also kind of wish I gave him a stock. The shield bearer isn't so bad. So let's get rid of the advanced officer. Or let's not.
Not even close. I need ammo.
We all need ammo. Well, we could flank him here.
I'm on it.
Yeah, this isn't so bad. Could be a lot worse.
Adjusting aim.
Okay, this is a free reload, thank goodness. That's a not what? What the hell's going on? Is it making up? Oh, this is so not good. It's really risky to do this. Except I need to kill that officer. I'm doing it.
There is no fear.
Oh, goodness. 100. I'm hoping this kills him. I really am. Finally! Good God. Hit, hit. Yes! Good. Isaac comes through. My freaking God, that guy, that officer took forever to get down. If we get a turn with no enemies here, wow, we did. That's shocking. We have two stocks, right? We have two stocks, right? Okay.
Affirmative. So, moving out.
I mean, we could slowly move in. All I need to do is get vision on that thing over there, which happens to be on the other side of the UFO. No wonder I don't get these missions very often. I should be glad for it. 41%. If I move here, I'm probably gonna activate someone. I think it's okay though. Yep, knew it.
Overwhelm them.
Freaking knew it. It should be okay, though. We could grenade this. And I think that's what our plan is, actually. They're just spread out enough that I can't hit both. Or can I? I can't really see... What the hell's going on? Yeah, this is not hitting both. They're spread out. They maintain spacing just well enough. I mean, that's okay. We can figure something out. Probably. Or I could launch yet another grenade in.
Heading out.
And I think that's what we do, actually. This blows up more than enough. So, yeah, I say we do this.
Bombs away!
Bombs away, and it gets a kill too, so that's nice. Which means we don't need to use stock. I don't like how resilient this UFO is. It's quite annoying. Okay, 54. Nope, no dice.
Now then, let's get going.
52. He's not dead. But he could be killed by a stock now, so... But we don't have anyone available. Well, okay, we do have someone available with a stock. Actually, we don't even need to use the stock. But, I mean, we might as well. I'm not even sure what we're going to do about that shield bearer in there, to be perfectly honest. I don't think he'll come out, so we don't need to deal with him right now. I think this is a safe move now. But I don't know if I want to do that.
Reloaded!
On the move.
I guess let's get him behind heavy cover. I could shoot a clutch shot at him, but I don't think that's worth it either.
Overwatch.
This guy's dead due to poison. Right? Yes. Good. Oof.
Overwatch.
Bye. Just gotta keep on advancing in, I guess. Oh my. Oh my god. I'm sorry, that is a shield bearer, right? That is a gutsy shield bearer. Actually surprised. Usually they don't try to do stuff like that.
We are the harbinger of your ascendance.
-71%, 53, we can't blow his cover up, so... let's do it. Lucky SOB.
You will regret your existence.
We might be getting reinforcements dropped on us, because I don't really know how we could prevent that during this time. I really don't know if we can prevent it, honestly. Could combust him. Brianna, please hit him. Was that a hit?
That armor's tough. Gonna need to reload soon.
Not bad, not bad. I'm pretty sure this hits armor, though. I mean, if it doesn't, great, but let's see.
Your mind is your weakness.
Come on. At least three.
That armor's tough.
That was really lame. Not ideal whatsoever. Do we have two stocks at the ready? No? Damn it. Various can't do anything. I mean, we could toss a grenade at him, but, like, I kind of don't want to.
Amazing, Zach.
Amazing.
Moving to position.
Don't trigger anybody, Zach. Thank you, Zach. 73% to hit. I think we do it. Whatever.
Target.
Yeah, I know. I know. Thank you for telling me that. I am fully aware of that.
Ready to go. Moving to Overwatch.
I'm not tossing their grenade. I don't think we need... Well...
I'll give it a try.
I'm not using a grenade. Oh my god, that was painful for him. He might just burn out, which means I don't know if he'll retreat or not. I don't see the point in retreating, to be perfectly honest. Are you effing kidding me? Wow. Shoot. Damn it. Yeah, that's what I was kind of worried about, but I still did not think that that was a full... Wait. Really? This is half cover? Well, damn it.
Position confirmed.
Grimori can kill him at least.
I've got it.
Well, we're not leaving now. Sorry, buddy, but you're definitely gonna die for that. Unfreaking believable.
on the move.
We just need to get to that station and disable the alarm.
I'm on it.
That's all we need to do. And yes, grenades are how we're going to go about doing that.
On the move.
I swear to God, that's so annoying. Losing someone else, freaking Isaac of all people, to a freaking shield bearer. God. I'm not even, yeah, forget him.
I'm on it.
Unfreaking believable.
I'll give it a try.
That's
a good idea.
Stupid SOB. Can someone come into our line of sight, please? God damn it. I'm honestly not sure. If we could blow this pillar up somehow, then, and this whole control center, then yeah, maybe we have line of sight.
Move into position.
I don't know if we do. We don't right now. So, and then I know the freaking soldiers tossed moronically. So if I move here, then we probably won't be able to get a grenade in. But we'll see. We'll see. We'll see. We'll see. We'll freaking see. Yep, knew it. Well, okay, fine. Just gotta blow that control center up. Please tell me it blew up. My God, are you kidding me? Well, let's move it further in then, because we don't have much of a choice. Shoot.
That's affirmative.
Still nothing. Damn, this sucks a lot. So maybe choosing a grenadier was not the right choice.
On the move.
I'm really worried about what this is going to reveal.
I'm on it.
Nothing, apparently.
Menace 1-5, that's the distress beacon.
Okay.
Move in and disable it before the aliens get a bead on the UFO.
Well, Brianna could do that on the next turn, then. Right?
On Overwatch.
I'm risking this.
On Overwatch. Scanning.
Nothing. Fantastic.
Heading out.
On your order.
How? What? Okay, good.
I'll give it a shot.
Whew. Contact cost could be kind of cool. Dark event, I don't really care about, so yeah. I can't freaking believe Isaac is gone. That's terrible.
I'm in.
We've knocked out the alien distress signal. Looks like the skies are quiet.
Sweet.
Hey, you hear anything?
Let's get ready to shoot people then, because that's what's gonna happen.
Moving.
Everyone get a window and get ready to fire.
Okay, sounds good.
Yeah, I know. It sounds perfect, really.
On your order. Overwatch!
If I have to.
Come get some. Affirmative.
Freaking Isaac.
Of course. I'll be right here.
Time to begin this fight. It's a normal mutant. That's good news, at least.
Hostile target down.
Oh. Flame Viper's dead. A four pack, huh?
Enemy is still up. It's still moving.
Oh my God. This is going to be terribly dreadful. Probably. Well, not really. We can neutralize two, maybe three. Can we hit three? No. So we could actually get a stun out on two with Grimori. In my mind, this is the best thing to do right now. So long as the target reticle does not go crazy. So, yep, that's damage and stuns. Stun for two. Okay, so a full turn. Next, we need to get rid of the Muton somehow. How are we gonna do that? No clue. Apparently this one's not in cover though, so that's quite interesting. I mean, if he's not in cover, allegedly, I'm just gonna shoot him.
Went off the armor. Guns dry.
Not dead, not quite, but that's okay. Percent, 83%. That could be a kill there. So after that, we do have two Mutons up still. I mean, not two Mutons, two enemies. Which makes me want to not actually use Alejandro. Yet. We could move in, go for a full on flank. I'm pretty sure there's nothing left on the map anyways after this, so we could afford to be a bit crazy. 81%. Ugh, come on, please kill him. Nice! Good critical hit.
Surprise, hey, Zach.
Flame Viper, I'm not worried about. We could have three shots at 57%. And I think we do that, actually. That's good. That's a good start. 47%. Was that hit? Really? Well, he's dead. He is freaking dead. Now what? I didn't expect that to go nearly as well as it did. Too bad I can't, for some reason, I guess it's because there's a stupid pillar in the way, but I can't see that other Flame Viper. It might be worth it to Frostbomb him. I guess let's just shoot this guy, because I don't know what else to do. That sounds like yep, that was a kill there. I'm tossing the frost bomb out. I think this is kind of a waste, but
on your order.
It basically guarantees we're not going to take damage and we can just sweep up.
Heads down.
So, no point in being cheap, I suppose, especially since I got Isaac killed already. Damn. Isaac was with us from the start, too. It's terrible. Really sad loss there. No free reload, but that's okay.
Ready to rock.
I think I could actually flank him, right? Really, I cannot. Shocking.
I nicked him.
You nicked him? Oh, flame vipers can be poisoned. Interesting. I could freak one out. I'd prefer to just kill him, though. 100%. Why can't everyone shoot that well? Wouldn't that be nice, Zach? Another down.
That's just amazing.
It is just amazing. Amazing, Zach. Maybe this will hit too. Dead.
Target eliminated.
Oh god, there is someone left here. Well, that's... That could have gone pretty bad.
It's killing time. Got it covered.
Who is left in this...
Headed there now.
...facility?
I'm on it.
And yes, I know there are notification sounds on, which I don't have off for this recording. So, that is fine. And I don't know if the actual notification can be seen, but I could see it.
Amazing, Zach.
Amazing. Well, I mean, we have the upper hand here pretty severely, I would say. We just need to not F up. We don't have that great of shots here, though. So that's the bad part. What is this, a trooper? Okay, yeah. So they're both capable of killing us. As with most aliens in XCOM, of course, but... Everyone's out of position, I hate this.
I'm on it.
I really hate this. Clutch shot's not gonna do anything, really, as far as I'm aware. So let's take 233%. Nope.
Come on, focus.
Oh, that's okay. Fire again then. 23. Great. We're kind of pinned down here, to be perfectly honest. And I'm not a fan of that whatsoever.
Overwatch.
Yeah, I gotta fall back. We're maintaining spacing enough that, like, a lot of these people can't do much of anything to us. Dense smoke would be the best option here, I think, because we get hit. Maybe not. Someone's gonna take heat. Everyone is behind full cover, correct? Yeah. So maybe in that case, we don't do dense smoke. Well.
Here,
yeah, I'm doing dense smoke. We could only affect 2, though, out of 5. So that's not. I always find this questionable, because why would you just not shoot at someone who's not in the smoke?
I'm burning up here.
Oh god.
Got me flanked.
Good job missing.
Getting a little too warm over here.
You SOB. Everything's freaking burning. Oh my god. But that's okay, whatever. Various, can you shoot this guy in the back? Because that's what you do. Oh, this would, wait. Yeah, that would be a flank. Okay. flank him. Die, MRF-er. You're not quite dead, but it's good enough. 39 will damage, damn it. That's huge. I guess just shoot. That doesn't seem like it's a hit, yeah. Just keep on firing until everyone's dead.
Hostile terminated.
Tyrion Fordring. Can you toss a grenade out far enough to hit that guy? I think you can. Well, yeah, actually you can. Okay, well, whatever. Blow him up to tiny pieces.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Good God. Freaking, we lost Isaac. I hate it. I really hate it. I shouldn't underestimate shield bearers at all. That one was extremely bitter, though. He had it out for Isaac heavy. Oh, poor Isaac. Damn it, I need to be more careful, I guess. Although, I mean, like, to be honest, it never crossed my mind that Isaac would get killed by a shield bearer. At all. Like, when I was making those moves, I did not consider the possibility that he would really get killed. And maybe that's because I was using Isaac literally as possible, I mean, as aggressive as possible. But, yeah, he and I paid for that. Well, we're up to 5 losses then. Or is it 4? No, we're up to 5. I think. Yeah, we're up to 5. Damn. I'm hoping it doesn't get much worse than that, but I mean, that is a heavy loss. I need to figure out. I think what we're gonna do before we end the episode is recruit someone else. Just because I want to end the episode on a bit of a happier note, or a possibly happier note. Holy hell, Isaac. Ugh. He did really well. Gun and run. That's kind of cool. Scouts watch. The rogue no longer has reaction fire penalties with Overwatch and can crit, but can only watch over small regions. What? I'm gonna go with gun and run. Well, Grimori, good job. Who needs to go to the bar and just relax for a little bit? Nobody, in my opinion, anyways.
Hello, Commander.
This morale mod's really cool because, like, it makes demoralizing the enemy a viable strategy, honestly. Because otherwise, like, the Advent troops are stone-cold killers.
I am still hard at work on the current research priority, Commander.
What can I do for you, Commander?
Right, I wanted to do this. So 5, yeah. Damn. Honorable, well, without the B. Honorable from the start to the end, Mr. Isaac. We'll miss you. I'll miss you. But I guess that's XCOM. Yeah, I guess that's XCOM. So, the question is now, do we recruit someone from the recruiting pool, or do we just buy someone that's a higher rank? I mean, buying someone that's a higher rank is usually the better idea. But honestly, I want to kind of recruit someone and build them up. Mary York. Yeah, I'm gonna recruit Fire Lord Ragnaros.
The machine is running full steam. We're picking up their transmissions even way out in the middle of nowhere.
Viktor Komarov. Is that a Call of Duty reference? I don't know. And Lazy Fell. Okay, yeah, cool. I will go ahead and proceed to hopefully not get my new two recruits killed. But I mean, we're gonna put them in GTS without exception, because that just gives them a little boost. Yes, and what would Ragnaros be? I almost want to say Shock Trooper. And we can make Lazy Fell an assault. Okay, well, we're set up for the next mission, of course, and then we're also getting a spark, so three potentially awesome people that we have to level up. I mean, that's fine, I like leveling people up. And that's it. So, with that said, thank you very much for watching. It must have been the smart rounds, because I really don't expect shield bearers to be able to hit their marks, honestly. So maybe that guy did have smart rounds. In any case, thanks for watching. My name is Krendis, and I'll see you on the next episode. And I'm actually not completely depressed this time about events that happened. So that's good, I guess. Or maybe I just become a bit more desensitized to losing soldiers. In any case, thanks. We'll see you later.